Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Aziza. I'm reading today for the sign of Aries for love and relationship for December 2020. Either you are crying or you are worried a lot and you cannot really sleep. You think about your person very much, and I get here your person think that you lied about something. You could be have a husband at home and you say, no, I'm not with that person. Or you could be not really being too honest about another person living with you. Or you're still dealing with another person, and I get here that your person think that you are not really being truthful or honest. Even though if you are even very truthful at this time, your person doesn't believe it and they think that you are playing games or could be lying about something. And I get here that if you have a person your person, I get here that they want still the relationship with you, but I get here that they have that feeling or image that maybe you are dealing with other people or sleeping with other people, and they are worried about it a lot. And I get here that they want to be happy with you, they chat with you, but they are not really sure about your sincerity. You want a relationship with your person, you want marriage, you want everything. And I get here that you are worried a lot that your person is really getting excited with someone else or dealing with other people, and maybe that they have a new relationship. I get here, you get your relationship with your person, be happy, just chat and flirt mostly. Because I get here that show the person that you are happy. You cannot show them that you are miserable or worried or tired or off. Because the more that you are upset, you are worried, you are sick, you are having problems and you complain, I get here your person doesn't really have that desire to keep talking. Well, if somebody love you, they will hear good and bad. But it looks to me that, some people get annoyed with the whole complaint over and over. And I get here, if you have a child from someone, maybe someone is accusing you, that's not my child. That's not really good. But I get here that it's just jumping into conclusions. So let's put it this way, that your person doesn't trust you. And I get here, you have been separated for a while, from your person. You want them to email you, text you, communicate in any which way. And you have been really waiting for a long time. And I get here, you are undecided to wait because it took a long time. Why your person is not giving you any attention? You want to understand that. You want to succeed with the one you love. You want a long-term relationship. You know this person for a while. You want things to get better here, for you two to be together already. You love each other no matter what here. But I get here that the person that you love, I get here they are coming back to you. You will get your wish, but they still not sure 100% to trust you. That's an issue of trust. It's not like you don't have an issue of trust, but your person have a lot of issue of trust. It's like here, the person that you want also, that they have been really trying to manage to pay their bills, try to work, try to get extra money because they spended a lot of money or they just lost a lot of money. And if your person looking for a job, I get here he or she will find a job. I get here your person love you very much, but they are confused at this time because of your effort. You do an effort, you cut it off, you fight, you argue. But I don't see that you are the person who's causing all of these fights and argument. Your person haven't been consistent or to be with you. For some of you, your person is not really around. Like, you know, maybe they are like, you know, in a different area also. Different country, different state. It's really far away. And they are trying to be really with you, but it seems to be the pandemic or COVID, like, you know, that it's not really making a lot of people to move forward in their life. But I get here, they want to find a way to be with you no matter what. Your person have been separated from you for a while. I get here that they are taking a lot of time to think, but the more you, they are taking longer, they get confused more. Like they say sometimes, like, you know, when you are too far away from the person or you don't see them face to face, it make you like, you know, think a lot, and it make like, you know, the heart not 100% loving until they see you again and open their emotions and feelings to you. Or at least, like, you know, you can see each other on the web camera, like, you know, or video chat. It's really best than just talk through text messages, because it doesn't work like that. Like, you want that connection because you miss that connection between you two. Heart to heart, face to face emotions. Because I get here that there is emotional distance from each other lately. You don't feel your person, and your person is not feeling, and they keep thinking left or right about you, good and bad, mostly bad. Like, you might be with someone else, lying about this, misunderstanding, you want them, you don't want them, like, in all of this. Your person can be really coming across, like, you know, as controlling, and they want to control your life. They want to control your mind. Whom you feel for? Whom do you think about? It's too much control, huh? They don't also want the obligation very much, like, you know, that. Like, they can be really having the heart, like, you know, to be really committed to their children, their own children, but not really for the whole family, that they are not really blood. You are in a struggle at this time and you don't know what to do. And you feel like, you know, you are alone. You want to share your ideas, you want to share, like, you know, your love, intimacy, plans, anything, like, you know, in your life with your person, but you feel like, you know, that your person may be, like, you know, gone with someone else, like, you know, you don't really feel that connection. No matter what, I get here, your person think that you are the one. They still, like, you know, want you and love you, but your person become moody on you, like, you know, in a way that they are mad at you about something you are doing. But I get here, your person is going to try to come back to you and be with you no matter what. You know, all of these thoughts, it's just only thoughts. But what's going to happen? Love. Great love is coming for you two to connect with each other again in person. And I get here, no matter what, both of you have a good intention. But sometimes, like, you know, your person think that you might be really not committed. They can be really not reliable also, maybe a long distance, or it could be like, you know, they are busy with something and they won't really, like, you know, to move forward. No matter what, they can approach you to move forward. That's what I'm picking on the end here. Like, you know, all of this blah, 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 blah is not really something that is really written on a stone or graved on a stone. What I'm picking on here, that you will get your wish at the end, no matter what. Well, dear Aries, I hope you enjoy the reading. If you need a private reading, please contact me on mysticalaziza.com, and that is my website. Please click on mysticalaziza.com, click on reading prices. You will find the whole information in it, how you call me, how much you pay, the prices and everything. The link for my website is below this video, and thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.